कैपिटल गेन टैक्स इज चार्ज्ड ऑन गेन अराइजिंग ऑन चार्जेबल पर्सन मेकिंग चार्जेबल डिस्पोजल ऑफ चार्जेबल एसेट्स. सो देयर मस्ट बी अ चार्जेबल डिस्पोजल एंड ऑफ अ चार्जेबल एसेट एंड बाय अ चार्जेबल पर्सन. So chargeable disposal of a chargeable asset by the chargeable person. So now who can be a chargeable person? So for CGT purpose, an individual or a corporation might be a chargeable person. So CGT consequences are applicable for both individual as well as a corporation. Now as far as the chargeable disposal is concerned, the definition of disposal is wider as compared to a normal disposal definition. So what is to be covered under chargeable disposal? The sale of asset or gift of asset, whether it's a whole or part of the asset. So a complete gift of asset, a complete sale of asset, or the part sale of the asset is called chargeable disposal. Similarly, if you exchange an asset, that is also considered as disposal. Similarly, any loss or total destruction of an asset. So if asset has been destroyed completely, then it's called the chargeable disposal. Similarly, any receipt of a capital sum that is derived from an asset as a result of compensation received due to damage of an asset, such as insurance proceed. And similarly, the receipt of a capital sum for surrendering of right of an asset. So this is the definition of chargeable disposal. And certain disposal are not considered for CGT purpose. Those are disposal as a result of death of an individual. And similarly, gift to charities. These disposals are considered as exempt, but these are taxable somewhere else, because IHT is also applicable on certain types of gift. Now, as far as chargeable assets are concerned, you can see that those assets which are not classified as exempt asset for the purpose of CGT are considered as chargeable assets. So you need to know the list of the exempt assets. And these are, number one, motor vehicle. If you sell any motor vehicle, including the vintage car, that is exempt for CGT purpose. Similarly, the main residence, cash available, certain chattels. There are different rules applicable on chattels. ISA investment, qualifying corporate bonds, gilts or the government securities, national saving and investment certificates, foreign currency for private use. If it is for commercial use, then it is not exempt asset. Receivables, inventory, any prize bond, and betting winnings. All these are considered as exempt assets, so there will be no CGT consequences on that. So it means that, first of all, there must be a chargeable disposal, and chargeable disposal related to other than exempt assets, then we will calculate CGT. So in order to calculate chargeable gain or allowable loss, you have to follow this pro forma. And this is for individual business. We'll deal with the corporation later on. So first of all, consider the sale proceed. At what price you have sold that asset? Or in case of any other thing, if sale proceed is not available, then insurance proceed, and other than that, so disposal proceed minus the selling cost. So you'll get net disposal proceed. And from that net disposal proceed, certain allowable expenditures are deductible. Number one, the purchase cost of an asset, incidental cost associated with purchase of assets, such as transportation or other things. And if there is any capital expenditure during the life of the asset in order to enhance the asset, then it is an allowable expense. So all these three will be deducted from the net disposal proceed. And if net disposal proceed is more than that, then there will be a chargeable gain or otherwise there will be an allowable loss. This particular pro forma is applicable on each individual asset. So if you sell two or more assets in a given tax year, then for each individual disposal, a separate pro forma is needed, and you have to then combine all the chargeable gain or allowable losses. Now, in order to calculate the CGT, another pro forma, identify all chargeable gain net of the allowable losses in a particular tax year. So if you have sold two assets, one incurred gain, other incurred loss, then net of that two assets and get the net chargeable gain. Then from the net chargeable gain, there is an annual exemption that is available for individual only. Remember, for corporation, there is no such exemption is there. And for the tax year 1920, the annual exemption amount is 12,000. So deduct from the net gain and you will get the figure of taxable gain and on which a rate is to be applicable. So CGT payable is taxable gain and a suitable rate that is applicable on chargeable gain. So Mr. A sold a holiday cottage at a price of 90,000 on 15th July 2019. It was acquired at a cost of 35,000 on 1st July 16. Additional expenditure incurred on 1st August 18 to improve the asset at a cost of 15,000. Selling expense were 1,000. Calculate chargeable gain. So we have to calculate chargeable gain on that. So let's make a pro forma. So we have sale proceed of that asset, that is 90,000. And from that sale proceed, deduct selling cost. And that selling cost, basically it's commission or other thing like that, 1,000. So we have net sale proceed. We have net proceed of 89,000 minus allowable expenditure. These allowable expenditure must be capital expenditure because revenue expenditure is not allowable. So the purchase cost, first of all, the purchase cost is 35,000. So purchase cost is 35,000. Enhancement cost is 15,000. So the total of 50,000 is allowable cost and this is deducted. So it will give us a figure of 39,000 and this is the chargeable gain. If this is the only chargeable gain in a particular tax year, then you can deduct annual exemption of 12,000 and then on the excess value, that is the taxable gain, the appropriate tax rate might be applicable.